everyone, Esther here from Esther-Astro-Healing. Thank you for tuning in and for supporting my channel. If you didn't subscribe yet, I hope you will. And perhaps after you listen to this video, so you can receive more future my videos and upcoming information. Today I want to discuss about solar eclipse, which is happening on December 14th, which is really in a few days. We start to feel usually energy of eclipses at least 5-4 days prior. So I'm sure we already start to feel this energy, and it's a very, very special solar eclipse. I have to tell you, I'm so excited about this video because I was working on it for the last few weeks. I'm going to provide information that I'm almost sure no other channel provided this information. This information will contain from Sefer Yezirah, Book of Formation, Book of Creation. Again, to remind you, Yezirah, it's correlate, correspondent, both words, creation and formation. So Sefer Yezirah provides a lot of information, and it's really known one of the number one spiritual astrological books was given to Abraham, Abraham prophet, our father. And there's a lot of mystical and profound information in Sefer Yezirah, and I found correlation with the Torah as well. If any of you study Torah, the five book of Moses, the Old Testimony, you know, Book of Torah and Old Testimony, it's not something you should understand directly. This it's a code, it's a lot of hidden information. This is why it's always recommended to study Zohar, because Zohar explain in more depth what really Torah meant to say. But Sefer Yezirah, it's an addition, very, very important book to study. But in order to understand this book and study, and again, I'm not claiming I understand this book. Every time when I'm reading, I study, and I say to myself, my God, the last time I was reading the same section, I didn't understand the way I'm understanding right now. So there's no end. Same thing with Torah. You know, when you really think why we listen every year, same thing, we listen every week. But if you really look what's happening in our life, everything what's happening in the Torah and what's really everything what's happening in the how Creator really provided so much tools, so much support, it's really correlate with our daily life, what's really happening with us. Now, today I want to discuss about solar eclipse, and as well, it's not just ordinary solar eclipse. This solar eclipse, usually solar eclipses, this type of combination happen every 18 years. Now, this particular solar eclipse, because the way how it's touching the Keto, which is south node, the karmic south node, which is really important, and I prepare for you really amazing information. It's like I was like myself, I was so excited when I found in Sefer Yezirah how it's connecting the Keto, the south node, how it's connecting with the last week portion, which is the called Vaigash, when Jacob received the second name Israel. And if you recall, when he was fighting with the angel Samech Mem, we don't really pronounce his name, and this angel actually compare, and it's in Sefer Yezirah is discussed as Satan is and as well it's connect to the south and north node, the dragon, which is we do have in our personal natal chart, and is extremely important because they both represent our karmic nodes, our past in our present lifetime, which is I'm going to go in depth in this video today, so definitely stay until end. Now, by end of this video, you will find information about your rising sign. I'm going to provide you really, really important tools, which is you can benefit at least for it next 6 months until the next solar eclipse. The way how it works, whatever's happened in the present solar eclipse, we do see effect until the next solar eclipse, which is happening in May 26, 2021. So I do recommend for you to stay. My video in the beginning is going to be general video, and then you will find your rising. I'm going to post 12 separate videos for each sign, for each rising. Now, if you don't know your rising, only then you can check under your moon. But if you do know your rising, the only thing you need to check is under your rising. I do not recommend to check under your moon or under your sun sign, because it's directly, again, it's directly connected to the rising sign, especially with the solar eclipse. And the information I'm going to provide for each rising sign, it's really the homework creation was want us to work on, and particularly house until the next solar eclipse, in order for us to really understand the lesson. And because each solar eclipse, it's really opening for us. It's created a certain level of darkness in order for us to sit tight and go deep inside to understand what's really, really, it's almost like we hear this more often, reboot, you know, it's like we need to really to go deep inside and understand what's happened. I'm going to share with you right now the some of the PowerPoint and images I create. So this is the image I wanted to share with you from the last week Torah portion, which is Old Testimony. It was called Vaigash. And I do recommend for you, if you study Torah, if you study Book of Moses and spirituality in Zohar, you probably know the story about Jacob, his preparation before his meeting with Esau, his brother. And before the meeting, he met angel. And this angel was really, really important for his spiritual growth, and as well was really, really important for him to receive, to earn the name Israel, which is, as you know, name Israel contain, each letter contained different name of prophet. Now, what's really important as well for us to understand about this event, while he was fighting with him, you know, I was listening to different commentary, different lectures of different teachers, different rabbis, and as well I was reading from different book of righteous people. While I was reading and trying to understand the whole idea, the importance of him to find the angel of death, the Samech Mem, we don't pronounce really his name, I was really trying to understand why this message was really, really important for us. And this message was, you know, why we need to really to understand. And in Sefer Yezirah, which is in Vaigash, and again, this is the first time when we receive, he received the name Israel, which is each spiritual person, according to Kabbalists, we all in potential can have a level of soul, which is connect to Israel, the level of our level of our soul, of our capacity of desire for the light, to receive the level of the light. Now, what I wanted to show you here, according to Sefer Yetzirah, it wasn't just angel in a human body with wings. It was actually Leviathan. As you know, it is in Sefer Yetzirah, what Sefer Yetzirah explained, the Samech Mem or Satan is also called, it's called Teli in Hebrew, meaning the dragon. Now, the dragon is the initiatory force of darkness, whereas the fallen angel, and again, the angel name is Ahriman, or again, is Satan, enters to coils, which is the Levatan, and empower and exist in immortal spirit, right? So it's also changes continually, and which can be compared to symbolize of motion of serpent. Now, what's really, really, and let me tell you where I'm going this. Now, this is the Sefer Yetzirah. This is exactly the image from the Sefer Yetzirah, and you can make a screenshot and read yourself what really Sefer Yetzirah explain. This is the location inside of our each chart. You know how we have a chart. The chart contains 12 houses. Each house represents different force of energy. Inside of this house, we have a south and north node. Now, so what did Sefer Yetzirah saying actually? Some have speculated the Tali, the Tli, might be referenced to the Amandi, the Ptolemaic system, imaginary line, design this spherical universe, which is turned fixed, connecting to the terrestrial poles, north and south. Look how cool it is. So basically, the Jacob, was fighting, not just any Satan, anything from outside. He's fighting the two forces inside of him. This is who we are. We came to this world to fight both forces. And those forces, which is south and north, north, this is additional information from Sefer Yezirah. This is how it's located in our chart between the signs. This is really profound. It's so magical. This is why I don't even understand how some religious community can say then astrology, it's not important. This is the essence of our soul. When you really know your astrological chart, when you really know your south and north node, and as well how it's reflecting from your moon, which is your inside world, right? Because your sun, it's really your sun represents your real desires. It's your life. It's your light force. It's your light force for for the life, and it's extremely important. So now when we think about it, right? For this solar eclipse, moon gonna completely cover sun with darkness. So what is the sun? Sun, it's extremely important planet in our chart. The way we is placed, it's really important. So when, for example, I look at people's charts, if sun replace high in the sky, for this person, it's much easier because what it's represented, it's represent our drive for the force of, for the life, our desire for the light, our learning ability, how much we want to learn. It's represent our father, in any supreme figure in our life, in how much energy we have in general, how much we love life. This is the sun. Now, moon represent our emotions. That's inside, our hitting what who we really are. Only we are know we are. Now, the moon now covers sun completely, right? And it's going to be in 29 degrees. Now, 29 degrees, I'm going to show you after sky. You're going to see yourself what's really happening because it's called, some people call it's war of planet. It's absolutely not true. It's called a parrot of planet because it's happening in December 14, as I mentioned, and it's happening in the 12th house, house of Scorpio. We're going to go through more information about that. I have really awesome information for you more to come. Okay, so right now, and just to mention to you again, the solar eclipse, because it's happening, and again, it's happening in 12th house, and it's going to be in about 2 minutes and 14 seconds. Usually once in the 400 years, we have solar eclipse, which is 7 minutes. Now we have 2.14 minutes. The last time this type of combination of the planets we had 400 years ago, and it was about in 1632. And there was a five planet, exactly the combination how we have right now. So it's really, really awesome. Now, if we're going further, look what's happened, what others explain about Ketu and Rahu, right? So here we have Ketu, which is south north, and here we have Rahu. Now, just for you to remind you, I made a video prior to about Ketu and Rahu, which is really important video. I made in end of December. I do recommend for you to look at it. Now, what is the really Ketu? Right. So now I'm going to explain to you a little bit more about Ketu and about Rahu, especially Ketu, because this is solar eclipse. We're going to have a Ketu in the Scorpio in the 12th house, which is going to be beside Venus. We're going to have beside Mercury. And then we have Moon and Sun. So we have a five planets all located in the 12th house, house of dark waters, so to say. And in Scorpio. So we really need to be prepared for this, right? We need to understand what force of energy we're fighting, right? So you see the Rahu, it's the head of the dragon. And Ketu, this is something we brought from our past lives. And this is the, we have end of the dragon, right? So let's go a few there. So this is the, again, nodes. This is how they look like. So this, this is the lunar nodes. Now, I wanted to show you another image just for you to really understand how it's looking in the sky. So this is the moon. And this is, we have a north node and we have a south node. Both nodes are when our soul, every time, each time we return to this dimension for another lifetime, we come into this dimension through force of energy of moon. Because moon, it's our inside, it's in Hebrew called Or Pnimi. And sun, it's our Or Makif, it's our surround light, and this is our inside light. Now, it's not just moon. With the moon, we have a company. those guys never leave Moon. They actually the only thing in the solar system going through together with Moon, according to the clockwise. All other planets we have in solar system against wise. So those twos, we're coming back with those new notes. They're extremely important. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about them, just for you to remind you, to refresh your memory, what energy they represent. In Sefer Yezirah, they're called head and the tail of dragon. In Vedic astrology, they call Rahu in Ketu. And in Western astrology, they call South and North Node. So just for you to remember the terminology, how it looks like. But again, just to come back for you to, again, you see this is the sun. So Moon on December 14 will be completely covering the sun. So it's going to be created darkness, right? So we're going to go a little bit more in depth. Now, something amazing and most amazing information, another thing, I just kind of correlation I want to explain to you about Aficus. I don't know if any of you heard about this combination, and the Aficus is a zodiac planetary place. This placement usually happened in the future while we're losing degrees. As you know, we are in Vedic sidereal astrology. This is more accurate because it represents sky, fixed sign, exactly what's happening in the sky. Western astrology, it represents more. I don't believe Western astrology is accurate, but again, it's philosophy, it's psychology more, and it represents seasons. The Vedic astrology, the sidereal Babylonian astrology, is represented directly fixed sign. Now, it is believed, and we do have 13 sign, and this 13th sign, it's called Aficus. Now, Aficus, it's really, really magical place in the sky, and it's exactly located between Scorpio and Sagittarius. Now, people who born, again, we need to check, but more or less, I can give you the information between November 29 to December 18. This is very special people. They have like really unique personalities. And the personalities, its traits of the personalities, which is Aficus, it's because it's between Scorpio and Sagittarius, you can imagine the intense energy they have. So it's, they're extremely curious people. They're open for changes. They're not afraid of challenges. They're very passionate. And they're very jealous in the nature at the same time, and the explosive temper. Sometimes they're really unpredictable. They even surprise themselves sometimes how suddenly they change from one mood to another. And they have a good humor, good, amazing sense of humor. They have very secretive nature and egotistical a little bit, and the thirst of knowledge, and they really want to understand knowledge in depth. And look what he's doing. And they have a sexuality magic as well. You know, those people who born on this sign, the way how they want to get know this their partner, let's have sex and I will understand you through the sex, really who you are. This is really how they operate, you know. So if you born in your chart as you think you're Scorpio, or you think you're in the beginning of Sagittarius, I do recommend for you to check. If you are in the degrees and you connect between November 29 to December 18, depends on 1 year, but more or less, this is your sign. And look what's happened here. This sign, represent healing in spirituality. This sign, because he's fighting the serpent, right? It's the healer. And he represent really the healing energy. And it's really connected to the final redemption, to Mashiach as well. I'm going to show you after in the sky where exactly it's locating and how. And I thought to myself, this is really amazing, because now we're talking about Jacob. Jacob was fighting the Satan. He's fighting the dragon. And look what we have at the same time of period of the portion of the Torah. The same period of time we're having right now, Aficus in the sky. Look how really light helping us. We just need to gain knowledge. We just really need to connect to the sky to understand This is why it says when we wake up in the morning, it's so good for us to observe sky, and at night to observe sky, to connect to the sky, because each of us came from different tribes. We came from so many different galaxies. We represent so many different forces of energies. And for us just to be stuck in this dimension, in a way it's this dimension for a lot of us felt like a jail for the soul, but without this jail, we cannot reveal the light. We cannot really understand the light of Creator, because the Creator need us to be here and to go through our process to every time to create different experience, and this experience going to the collective consciousness. This experience extremely important to finish work here, which is called Mashiach, Messiah, the final redemption, the collective consciousness, right? I thought it's super cool how things really coming together. I was so exciting. On Saturday, when I was after the Torah reading, I opened Sefer Yezirah, Book of Formation. I would start to read. I, for the moment, start to cry just for the awesomeness of the tools, of the energy, of the support we get from sky. I said to myself, this is unbelievable. World really need to hear that. You guys need to understand this eclipse. It's extremely important. It's almost light preparing us to before the great conjunction, because the Jupiter and Saturn are going to get together, going to create this amazing star. First time in 800 years. I'm going to create separate video. I did make video just for you to introduce for you a little bit different idea. What is really Saturn and what is really Jupiter as a righteous consciousness. I'm going to create new video in a few days. Just watch my future post. But this one, I thought it's absolutely awesome. Now, what I wanted to show you another thing. Okay, let me just go through that. Let's go right now to the chart. This is the chart of December 14. This is what's really going to happen in the sky. And look what's happening here. We have here five stars. Like I told you, we have a moon, we have a sun, and we have a Mercury, and we have a Venus, and we have a Ketu, which is South Node. And don't forget, we have a Pluto, which is very close as well, which is not helping, right? So Pluto is another force of energy, which is 29 degrees. Look how many 29 degrees we have. It's extremely important. Now, what's really important for us to remember as well, this eclipse will have effect for at least next 6 months, as I mentioned, until next solar eclipse, which is May 26, 21. So this is why by end of this video, definitely watch about your rising. I'm going to tell you exactly where in what placement in your chart the rising will be affected, and there's going to be a lot of information for you to understand and work on it. And it is very important creative karmic time. I have to tell you, it's a special before the great conjunction. And I only can compare, like, imagine somebody you know or somebody you knew was preparing for a very important physical operation. So your doctor told you, then, you know, before the operation, at least a week before, you need to stay on a certain diet, you need to stay on a certain lifestyle in order for your body will be more perceived, more ready for such a, you know, such an important interaction. So you need to stay and to prepare your body, right? Another thing I can compare, it's like, you know, those people, the surfers in the sea, when they preparing for the big wave. So when you're preparing for the big wave, you're not just sitting and waiting for a big wave to come. You're working with the small waves. You practice, you train your physical body, you train your resistance, you train your mind, you wanted to understand how the small or medium waves work before the big wave come. Now imagine people who do not connect to spirituality, who really live in 1% on daily life and constantly affected by any cause and effect, and they don't really understand, they don't even connect to the bigger picture, don't understand really of law of creation. Those people will be really, really hitting by these upcoming events. Now, those of you which is connected and consider yourself a spiritual person in, you know, we all in work in progress. There's no such a thing, I'm very spiritual. When people telling me I'm very spiritual because I do yoga, because I eat certain food, it has nothing to do with spirituality. You just do that because you feel better, you become a little bit, but real spirituality, when you are in the midst of chaos, and you really know how to use your tools. This is real spirituality. This is what really Jacob was fighting with. He was fighting for us. Don't forget, Jacob represents center column energy. If you recall one of my videos, when I made video about Mars, and we were talking about the Mars was represent energy of Gvura, of judgment, and then we have energy of Chesed, then we have a filament, the center column energy, and this is the Jacob. And why it's really important for us to connect to the energy of Jacob. It's not just some righteous person who left thousands of years ago and we have some nice story. No, he's the chariot of the force of energy of Tiferet, the force of energy which is represent center column energy. Without Jacob, we cannot bring final redemption. Yes, we all aware about the, you know, Mashiach ben David, the Messiah of David, and the other tribes have Messiah of Jesus. They all represent very important center energy. I'm not here put anyone less or more important. Each of us, we came from different tribes. We came to do our work, and we have to be very careful how we justify it or to be righteous by saying I'm more important than you are. Absolutely not. Each tribe extremely important. There's a reason why we all exist. There's a reason why certain prophets came to this lifetime, but we all have this force of energy inside of us. And this is why it's extremely important. There's nothing more important. It's to be focused and balanced at the same time. This is the contradiction of spirituality. Like, remember we discussed the freedom when you look at the sky, and sky, you know, it's everything free. But in the same time, each star has his own place. Each star, he knows his place and know his existence. Sorry, I'm just going to need to drink a glass of water. 1 second. So just to come back to you, to my initial thought, those of us then study spirituality and live spiritual life, with our behavior, the way we are with other people, we are ready for this big wave, I'm sure, right? So, and this is why it's extremely important for us to understand the spiritual person. What makes spiritual person is the small details, is the small things, right? So what is really sun? Let's really just to remind ourselves, what does the sun represent? Sun is the force of energy, is the our life. It's like I said, it's extremely important. When I look at people chart in the way how sun operate usually in your natal chart, I can tell a lot of things, how you initially excited about life, how you recover from some falls. You know, we all have ups and downs, but sun help us to recover quicker when we do know how to use our sun. Now, look at this degree we have in 29 degrees, right? Now, what's really, really magical, this is not just any other combination, because it's in the house, look at this over here, because it's in the 12th house, and we have a south node, which is represent extremely important star called Antares. So let's go to the sun. So the Antares, right? So the Antares, it's one of the very important stars inside of the sign of Scorpio. It represent leaders, it represent generals, and is one of the few constellation that look like it is name. You see, this is the Scorpio. There's no many constellation look exactly the way how it named, right? And this is the star Antares inside of the Scorpio. It's a star which is inside of the heart of Scorpio. So it's really important star. If usually when I do people chart, and when I do have, when you have three or more or less degrees closer to the star, this person has a really tremendous understanding about deep spirituality, about esoteric knowledge. They have a huge desire for it. In Antares, it's mean anti-Aries, so anti-Mars. You understand? So it's likely, because astronomers in ancient time this reddish looking similar to the red planet. You see, look at this star. This is huge. If you look at this, this star is bigger than sun. And this is tremendous huge star. And this star actually fighting with Mars. And you think, how come? Because Scorpio is one of the planets represent Scorpio, it's Mars, which is Pluto. It's more connected to Scorpio, to be honest with you, than Mars, but still Mars is represented as well. So the planet, in fact, and sometimes get Antares, a red planet, travel across night sky as well. So if Antares replace Sun for to say in solar system, it's you know, it would extremely beyond the orbit of fourth planet like a Mars. So we can see here in this image the Antares showing in contrast of the other star, Arcturus, and our Sun as well, right? So notice the two stars and the tip of the degree of Scorpio. I'm going to show you, right? Look at this tally tail, right? And this is another star. It's called Shower. Nose is a stinger, right? So this is not just any solar eclipse, guys. This solar eclipse connect to both very important stars, Antares, and this represent, and it's connected to the sting of Scorpio, right? Which is, I have to tell you, ancients used to say, when we have such a combination in sky, you know, the sting of Scorpio, especially when we have a people, you know, I mentioned prior, before as well, the star, it's connected to the sting of Scorpio. There's a two energetical force contained at the same time. It is a sting, it can poison you, and at the same time, it can heal you. Our righteous explain in the Talmud, it says that actually Scorpio connect to the final redemption, to Mashiach, to Messiah. Why? Because at the same degree, it can be poison, at the same degree, it can be healed. So it represents both of us. And those of us who have a important, you know, Scorpio in an important location in your personal chart, I do recommend for you to check, because you can really, you need to work on the Scorpio you have in your chart. It's extremely important, because sometimes we can be, so to say, unpredictable the way how do we react things, especially those of us who have a Scorpio, like let's say your rising, your moon, your sun, your Venus, your Jupiter, your Mercury. It's extremely important. So this is, I thought to share with you. So you will, so let's come back to the sky right now. So look what's happening here. So right now we have a Mercury as well. Now Mercury here on 27 degree, and we have a South Node. So all of them right now in the same house. So imagine you have a roommate, five roommates in the one room. Each roommate contains completely different energy, and it's a dark room. You cannot really see. So now by sitting in this dark room, you really need to rely to on yourself. You feel a little bit overwhelmed. You feel uncertain. You feel there's a darkness, but in the same time, you have a total trust. You have a total trust in understanding what's really happening. You understand? It's extremely. And look at this Venus. You understand? Venus is well over here in the head. It's in the fifth degree, and it's in the head of Scorpio. So everything. So we're going to be feeling really intense, dark energy. We, especially because it's feminine signs, especially women, and anyone who have more feminine sign, feminine energy inside of them, they're going to feel even more. This is why it's really, I don't recommend, even start from today, don't eat meat. Don't accept, if you celebrate Saturday, if you feel you want to connect to meat, by all means, but as light food as possible, because you need to help your body to connect to this force of energy, instead to make you, you know, more heavy and to overwhelm, you need to help yourself, right? So it's really important. Now, Mercury is conjuncting Keto almost exactly in 25th degree. You see, we have 27 and 26. They're going to be conjuncting each other in 26 actually degree. And, you know, that connect to the loss. So it is indicates the losses around communication, information that is given to us by media, by other people. Please, please do not listen right now to media. Do not give your energy. Do not overwhelm yourself to anything. This is the time for total transformation. Before the Jupiter and Saturn, which is going to happen on 21st of December, I strongly recommend for all of us to stay low profile. Do not look at other people, so to say, fails and luck, what's wrong with them. This is the time of really reflection, the time to understand what is the bigger picture, where I came from, who I am. You understand? So new ways of seeing and understand our reality. it will arrive inside of us. You will see, you will have a much deeper desire and understand who you are. What does really spirituality mean for you? Because we need to understand through the lack and pain, we can reveal more light. When room full of light, how much light you can reveal there? But now light put us right now in a dark room. In order for us to activate the light and to see how much light we have inside of us, and we can really act as a creator, right? On our higher self, the truth about our existing, our purpose this lifetime, what is out there? You know, we're going to ask, because of it's in Scorpio, Scorpio, it's such a metaphysical deep sign. We're going to ask, what is really out there? You will be surprised. The next year soon, people are going to talk about aliens like it's normal thing. Why? Because it was always there. It was hidden for us for no reason. They tried to protect us, to limit us. Now they have no choice. Now we're going to ask questions. We're going to feel. You see, this is the same thing with social media and with technology. It can destroy people, make addicted, but it can reveal so much light. So it's up to us how much we allow certain information to come and how we're going to work with this information. Is this information going to make us weaker? Or this is information actually, we're going to pick up exactly what we need for our spiritual growth, right? So it's about existing purpose, what is out there behind the galaxy and so much more. And what is really kindness? What is really kindness and with no agenda? Why we should feel other person pain? Why we should care for other person? People, we need to understand to care for other person, it's very practical, spiritual. And what I love about Scorpio, you know, imagine to come to this lifetime with the Scorpio sign in your sun, your rising, or your moon. This is the soul took upon themselves so much energy. This is why Scorpio, when they get to spirituality, you know how many people, they're constantly looking for spirituality. They move from one spiritual school to another, and they're constantly looking to be happy. Spirituality is not to be happy 24 hours. Spirituality is to understand when you in your dark moment, this is real spirituality, how you use this dark moment. This is why Scorpios are so amazing. I love Scorpions. It's one of my favorite signs. Why? Because they're so deep. When any challenge comes, they don't jump. They used to do this intense force of energy. They're very real. They have a huge commitment. When they love from all their heart, they can be a little bit cuckoo if something sometimes not going the way and can be unpredictable. You know, like a story about the scorpion and camel, when he asked camel to drive him because Scorpio says, you know, they cannot be inside of the water, they're afraid of water, and there was a huge flood happening, and Scorpio, I'm going to give you quickly the story just for the sake of fun, just a comparison. And please, Scorpios, I told you I love you, I'm not here, I'm nothing against you, I'm just telling you about nature of Scorpio. If some of you know the story, great. If you don't, I think you're going to enjoy this story. So there was a camel, the Scorpio came to camel, you know, and told him, you know, I want to be your friend and I need your help. Can you please, can I sit on you on the back of you, and you can drive me to pass through this water flood? So camel, he was smart. He knows the Scorpios, they're unpredictable. He said, please, just don't stink me while I'm going to help you. He said, no. Why would I do that? I need your help. So he was driving everything. As soon as they arrived to the desert. And before, and suddenly a camel feel he got the stink from Scorpio. And he's like, oh, why did you stink me? He said, I'm so sorry. It wasn't my intention. It's my nature. So this is how Scorpios, this is why Scorpion connect to the final redemption, because you know how to overcome. And one thing I forgot to mention, really important, because it's in the stink of Scorpion 29 as well. What's happening, this vaccine, it can be very poison. I'm sorry I have to tell you guys, those of you who pro vaccine and who think it's really safer, this particular vaccine, I don't have good news. I'm talking from perspective of astrologer. It can be very poison. And in general, be very careful of words right now. This period of time can be very poison. I literally recommend until end of December, before we enter into the new energetical a corridor, because we're right now literally between doors, the one door closed, another door not open yet. So after the great conjunction, the way how we will be prepared, and I can tell you this eclipse, it's lifesaver. It's literally taking us to the, such a darkness, such a low energy in order for us to really, to pick ourselves up, to really show Creator then how much the light of Creator we can use inside of us, the force of the Creator, right? So not to repeat myself too much, but again, this period of time, it's, I can, you know, I'm looking at the sky and everything what's happened, and I'm telling myself how much love and support we have from above, how much our ancestor lineages, they cheer for us, you know, they're cheering for us, they really care for us, they really, you know, what they really want us growth, because, you know, we need to remember, those of us who's in spirituality, there's a lot of souls waiting for our growth, and with our growth, they're growing as well, right? So to, before I'm gonna start with rising signs, I prepare a surprise for you. So I wanted to tell you about, as you know, this Hanukkah is coming, this coming Thursday. And Hanukkah is the time of miracle. The Hanukkah, it's extremely, extremely important time. And the solar eclipse will be happening on the fifth day of Hanukkah. And you think about, we have five planets and we have a fifth candle of Hanukkah. And this day, according to ancient, I found this information from the Babylonian ancient astrologers. It says then that we need to close our eyes. It's extremely important to meditate on the day. First of all, on Hanukkah, those of us who celebrate, it's one of my favorite time. It's the miracles. It's connected to Jupiter. While you celebrate Hanukkah, you celebrate Jupiter as well, right? Which is the essence. This holiday connect to final redemption. We know the only two holidays who remain with when Mashiach will come, final redemption, it's a holiday of Hanukkah and holiday of Kippurim. And both of them connect to Jupiter. And you will think, you know, now we have a great conjunction coming. How everything connected, it's absolutely unbelievable. I personally, very exciting. When I look at all of this happen, people so afraid. You can hear to other astrologers, my goodness, prepare. No, this is literally the Olympics we were waiting for. This is what really can take our humanity to the next level. So we need to really to connect to our soul, where we came from. We are such a big souls. We're creators. We are walking creators. We need to understand that this is extremely important to have this appreciation. And so what we need to do, we need to close our eyes and we need to make a wish. What we really ask from the Creator. And the way how we need to ask, like it's already exist, like it's already happened. And when we're going to do this, this is going to be a moment of manifestation, because in this dark moment, we're going to create the seed of the light, right? So it's going to be on December 14th. I don't recommend to go outside. If possible for you to stay home the whole day until next day, it's great. Connect to ancient knowledge, extremely important. And my next, please watch the video about your rising sign. I love you guys. I wish you many, many blessings. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for the next videos. Dear Capricorn, for you, the Cat to the South Node will challenge you on the 11th house. Not to challenge you, this is the opportunity for you really to understand your spiritual work for next at least 6 months until next solar eclipse. And more than that, because this is the same location Keto will place in your chart in the 11th house for the next 2 years. So this is really, it's really positive, actually. I'm looking at it because this is represent your sister house of Aquarius, and it's the same planet, Saturn, Shabtai, right? So this is really great, great opportunity. So let's just go over what does really 11th house represent. 11th house represent good fortune. Really, it's the happy house, consider. And it's community, friendship, friends, the goals, the inspiration we have, right? So 11th house, it's your hope and wishes, money, wife, good children, big house, you know, the big desires you have for things around us as well. Your friends, again, your network circle, your older, if you have older siblings or maybe cousins, this is another good opportunity. Incoming gains and strong car, it's really strong karmic house. And I will tell you why, because, you know, it's represent friendship, like I said, older in community, and it's important spiritual people, by the way. You will have opportunity to connect to important spiritual people. And this is really the house who have a really deep connection to the righteous, to sages. So I really recommend for you for this period of time to study the work of tzaddikim, the work of righteous people. It's going to be really benefit. You're going to get so much support from it. And this house can help you really increasing financial sustenance as well. So you just need to evaluate what this represents for you. It's really positive house. You know, a lot of people are going to have much heavy work. In your case, it's a lot of good opportunity for your spirituality, the way you understand your duties for humanity. Understand your spirituality, religion, because you, Capricorn, can be religious in a sense. But at the same time, when Capricorn gets to spirituality, is take a time, then he stay there forever because he's practically understand. Then spirituality is practical. This is the only way to live, especially nowadays. So it's our perception of fate, you know, our belief system, everything then give us purpose in our existence, you know, in this dimension. It's really important. Important. So also very important and unique point, the way we communicate with our inner personality, in with our creator within us, and the way how we see and communicate with the outer universe. Because remember, this is house of Aquarius. Aquarius is number one sign for spirituality to communicate with the universe, to for the other galaxies. So you will have the opportunity to come out from the box of the ambition and career oriented, and to really understand the bigger picture of spirituality. It's going to blow your mind away. You will see by end of this process, it's going to be so liberating for you. You're going to really operate differently because it represents the way God speaks to us, you know, this house. It's pushing us toward well-being of entire mankind. So it's connected to the bigger picture of other people. You're going to have opportunity to, without doubt, this primary role is why we're all here, to become like God. And this is amazing house for you, right? So what is really Keto will push you, your sign for this house? It's your ambitions and things about what you're thinking about your own success. Try to be in service of others, you know, create leaders in your own circle, in your work, in your community. If you leader in the leader positions, make sure people who work under you, you will create, put them in front and they will see that. They will give you all their heart and soul for that because they will see how much you care. It's actually asking you to let go of some friends, some friendship, perhaps they're not supporting you in your spiritual work. And to improve your current friendship, the community, how much you invest in the community, your older siblings, it's really important. If you don't have, you can connect to the, your cousins, another family member, but specifically this house represents older siblings. And the people, you know, the older people, the sages, like I mentioned before, the way we understand our duties for humanity, I can't stress enough, the spirituality, not religiosity, you know, our perspective of faith, beliefs, everything then give us purpose, and your reputation. I know your reputation always very, very important to you, but this time it's going to really count and come from the bigger picture. Like really, because don't forget, your sign, one of the signs that connect to Mashiach as well, before it was given to Aquarius, initially was given to you. So something was there, need to be, you know, revealed and as well transformed in order for you to be ready for this new consciousness. And you are ready. You're such a high quality people. It just for you, just like I said in the beginning, just to come out of the box and to connect to humanity from the new way and to understand spirituality. So my dear Capricorn, there's nothing more I can wish you to awaken the light of creator within you, you know, to really understand what is mind over matter, why it's so practical to be spiritual and consider others before you consider yourself, right? To help collective consciousness with your transformation, you will, so we all can bring the Messiah, Mashiach, closer, the final redemption. And with that, you know, to end the pain and suffering, the whole illusion we experience in this dimension, which just doesn't make sense in the upper level. So I wish you many, many blessings and much love. All the best. Bye-bye.